My marriage is a total failure. My kids think I'm an idiot. I spent 22 grand on a nightclub that never opened its doors. I might as well have just took it straight out of the bank in £5 notes and chucked it down the fog. It would have been quicker.
We all make mistakes, man. Oh, look at those two.
I wouldn't care, but I'm gone and baldy.
You're not, man.
I am, man. I've got to face up to it. I'm losing my hair.
Can't tell from the front, Tosca. What about those two?
I don't know if I can be bothered tonight, Geordie.
Pull yourself together, man. There's nothing the matter with them.
Have you noticed how all the women seem to be getting younger?
Right, let's apply the system.
Except the ones we get.
If you absolutely had to shag every woman in this room, what's your top two?
Definitely.
Hey, how's me hair?
Champion.
Compliments fly when the quality meet.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wondering in the night what
would. Can we swap over, Tosca?
What for, like? You're sick of my body already, Olive.
It's me, Tosca. I've got this thing about baldy men.
Well, the National Executive would never accept me as a candidate.
If the constituency want rid of Alan Payne and select you instead, then nobody can stop us.
The NEC can't fault us, Nicky, if we do it absolutely by the book.
Hiya. Done it again.
Right.
We'll go. Hiya.
How are you doing? Hiya.
See you tomorrow then, Nicky, yeah?
Cheers, mate.
See you later.
Okay.
Is that the one you're shagging like?
Goodness me, what a question.
Hurry up, man.
Tor.
Here.
Find Bridges. Latest issue.
Okay, Tor.
You can throw it wherever you throw all the rest. Oh, yeah, there's a boat I want to show you.
A boat?
You don't have to read it. Call in something.
Geordie, man!
Has he left home or what?
Hey, don't ask me. Where's Tosca?
Gone for some croissants.
Some what?
We noticed there was nothing for breakfast, so Tosca offered to go out and get some croissants, he said.
He's gone home, man.
Does he not live here?
About time and all. He barely thinks my throat's been cut.
Time to go, ladies.
Tosca said to wait.
Drug squad.
Give us a call.
Yeah. Will do.
You need a season ticket at the Clap Clinic, you.
What do you got?
Coke.
I'll take it down Monday. Call around the middle of the week.
Can you not go today?
It's me signing on day.
I hear your friend Barrett's back on the street.
Is he? Good luck to him.
I thought you were mate.
Piss off, Martin.
All right. Don't forget that book. Has some very interesting things to say about corrupt policemen.
Righto. Great.
Okay, Oldfield just left Peacock's flat. We're gonna follow him. Over.
Go ahead, Conway. Follow him.
Come on, you two, you're late.
Hurry up, Anthony. Is Kiss Bernie?
I'll see you later.
Yeah.
Introducing her party's manifesto, Mrs. Margaret Thatcher declares.
What we want.
You just missed them.
Not in details. Nah, I saw them.
Had to practically force Anthony out the door.
Well, he doesn't like school, he's at that age. What's the matter with Bernie?
You haven't got a clue, have you? Where were you?
Look, I'm trying to have a conversation about the kids, so don't change the subject.
The subject is, where were you when it was Bernadette's netball final?
Oh, bollocks. I forgot. See, I ran into Jodie after work and I had a few, and by the time it was home time, I'd had too many to drive, so...
Tosca, don't be pathetic. Look, I ask nothing for myself, but you can't just turn your back on those two.
Hey! Now, come on, they want for nothing.
You're never here, Tosca. For God's sake, you're not 17 anymore. You're 35. You've got responsibilities that need you.
Need us? Sometimes I think they don't even like us.
No, I don't think they do. But they still need you. You're their father.
God, I've made a mess of my life. A total, total mess.
Sorry.
Hi, kids. Claire, you've got to share. Play nicely or else.
I want a divorce, Mrs. Cox.
Hey, why are they boarding the flats up?
Why?
Yeah, why?
Because I've spent 8 years campaigning to have them condemned, that's why.
Not wrong with mine. Best flat I've ever had.
Yeah, well, the cockroaches moved out of yours, couldn't stand it.
I read a book once. Before the Bears Bumper Christmas Annual.
Right. This is a book about police corruption in London in the 60s.
Encyclopedia, is it?
Roy Johnson's inquiry into the Met and the Dirty Squad connection.
There was no Dirty Squad connection. They made sure of that.
Johnson was now close to lifting the lid on the Soho rackets. But when Coburn announced his intention to question George Peacock in
person... Hey, am I in it? Give a look!
He immediately dealt a death blow to the whole inquiry. Within 24 hours, he had been replaced as inquiry leader by none other than John Solway, head of the Dirty Squad.
Yeah? So?
It also dealt a severe blow to George Peacock, a notoriously heavy drinker who had become too talkative for his own good.
Well, yeah... That was about it. Then you would probably talk. I didn't really give a shit by then. So they stitched us up to get us out the way.
The inquiry was over, Geordie.
No. Went on for months, man.
9 months, but it was over. Roy Johnson's report was written. It was on Claude Seabrook's desk well before you were arrested. So, why?
I'd been having this affair with Barrett's mistress.
Ah.
Got pretty knocked. Didn't know we got that knocked. Bastard.
This was this Julia.
Jules. Julia Allen.
I'm sorry, I didn't realise. So, Barrett had you stitched up because of her? Simple as that.
Looks like it, yeah. Anyway, she got her own back for both of us. She gave evidence against a lot of them. She knew them all. She'd been to bed with half of them in the line of duty.
Doubt if I could have handled that.
No. Nor could I.
I was serious.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, to you, Jules, wherever you are. Thanks for the drink. Hey, why don't we go out sometime?
Geordie, hang on a minute.
I've got this little assignation. Well, actually, she's quite a big assignation.
Geordie, sit down a minute. Please. Postscript. As this book was going to press, I learned of the death of Julia Allen, whose evidence helped to finally nail the Dirty Squad. She died in a fall from a balcony window at her home. A jury at Southwark Coroner's Court recorded an open verdict.
Unbelievable sex. I mean, it was unbelievable. I've never felt like that about anybody before or since. Everything made sense when I was with her. It was the only time. I was just me, not this mishmash inside. Because normally, you know, it's just a sort of blizzard, really. And, don't really get it. Don't really get what's going on. But when I was with her, for just that little time, about 12 months, the blizzard stopped when I was with her. When it was just me and her.
What did I tell you? Take a picture of that face. No, don't. It'd smash the camera. What's the matter?
On the scrap heap, son.
Hello, Felix.
Hello, Roy.
Day off.
Aye, first of many.
Ah. Cup of tea.
How's Eddie Wells? Wouldn't know. Never seen. Well. He worked hard to get him elected as an independent in 74. First thing he knew, he's back in a party.
I always thought it was a pity men like you didn't stay in politics.
I've nothing to offer, Roy. Not in the world of Donoghue and Connor. I think you described the same thing, didn't you?
Now what?
Nope. See, you went back into the police after the war. I should have done something like that. I should have took a different turning. Where I came back to a young wife I'd never lived with and a bairn I'd never seen. We needed a wage, somewhere to live. So I went back in the shipyards without a trade. Now the yards are shutting. So, that's that. Well, you've got work to do.
If you do see Eddie, tell him if he doesn't do something about that allotment of his, I'm complaining to me MP.
Wants Nicky as the Labour.
He's your candidate, not the Labour candidate. You're a Trotskyite, and so are you, and so are you.
We are all members of the Labour Party.
That's right.
In a wind shape, man.
Look, come on, please have a rational discussion.
Why should we discuss with people who are only interested in power?
None of this changes anything. Can we get to the point?
We live in this constituency, you
this
don't.
Not you.
Alan Payne served this constituency for 20 years.
Alan Payne's not set foot in this block of flats.
We all know what you're up to. Alan Payne should be here.
That's crap and you know it.
Look, we all want the same
thing. Why, for the last 5 years, have you been kicking the Labour government?
We have not spent the past 5 years kicking anybody.
Well, you're not an impartial observer. That's common knowledge, Dick. Come on.
You know, if you put half as much effort into insulting the Tories as you do your own comrades in the working class.
What do you know about the working class, for God's sake?
You're a frigging polytechnic lecturer!
Never mind all this. The NEC Transport House, the front bench, will not accept this man as candidate, no matter how many votes he gets.
Say that again.
If Hutchinson is selected, this constituency will be overruled by the leadership.
And that's democracy, is it?
It's fact.
I think you're bluffing.
Nicky and his pals are after deselecting Alan Payne.
Oh, why, Alan's been totally useless, Eddie.
I know.
I mean, he stood by for 3 years while he took over his constituency. He's an idle sod.
I know.
If they decided to move in your constituency and drive you out of your seat, would you have just sat back and let them?
No, I wouldn't.
No. So what's the National Executive going to do about it?
Well, they got three choices. Alan Payne and split the party. Nicky and split the party, or else they can come up with a compromise candidate. No?
No. One, I'd never be an acceptable candidate to Nicky and the Trots. And two, I'm not ready to leave the kids and so on off to Westminster. Yet.
Tosca could take care of the kids. Yeah, well, I told him he'd say that. You're turning down the safe seat. You haven't got a problem opposing Nicky, have you?
None at all. But none of this is on the agenda for me just now, Eddie.
Of course we in the Conservative Party want to win. But let us win for the right reason. Not power for ourselves, but that this country of ours, which we love so much, will find dignity and greatness and peace again. There is a cause that brings us all together and binds us all together. We must learn again to be one nation, or one day we shall be no nation. That is our conservative faith. It is my personal faith and vision. As we move towards government and service, may it be our strength and inspiration. Then not only will victory be ours, but we shall be worthy of it.
What can I say? Whatever I say, you're not going to believe me.
Who helped her through the window?
See, what it is, Geordie, nobody...
I'm talking to the organ grinder, not the monkey! Look, why me? I haven't even seen her since I come out. Well, I've seen her. I mean, she used my clubs. I mean, she was still a good oar. You know that, Geordie. Though, I think she was on the way down when she died. If you pardon the expression. Shut up, that's not funny. Sorry, mate, no offence. Christ, I was screwing her before you was. Geordie, nobody killed her. Nobody had reason. We've got enough with the bill. We're going through a delicate period of reconstruction. Look, mate, she was getting old. Her tits were beginning to sag. You know what women are like, Geordie. Poor Geordie. Poor Jules. These are hard times for the little.
Open up! Open up and we'll batter the door in!
Give it a shot.
Put that down.
You see, the thinking these days is there never really was any kind of organised corruption. It was just individuals.
A whole squad?
Acting as individuals. This is what people have misunderstood.
I was the bagman for years. I paid money every week here in these offices to Solway and Chapel. It went right along the corridor.
And it was rooted out.
They let Chapel out. He's a rich man.
A technicality.
A deal! Still going on, isn't it? That's why Julia Allen was killed. She was talking to somebody, wasn't she?
All I did was look into the circumstances of the suicide. Well, the death. And give evidence to the coroner's court. There's no investigation, no high-level scandal, and that is the God's honest truth.
Why did she kill herself?
She seemed to believe she was being persecuted.
Why a window? Why not a bottle of aspirin?
Well...
You lying bastard! Campbell was out in 10 months. Solway was out in 2.5 years. I did more than that for nothing! The people that let it happen are still here, aren't they, eh?
They're all long gone.
The Commissioner's question is quite justified. How did this decline in our public standing happen and what do we do now? But for my money, the answer is connected with a general moral decline for which we may now be asked to pick up the bill. Now, if the lady wins this election, and we're asked to deal with the consequences of past political failures, and the signs are, as Mick says, that we are going to be asked, then what we say to the politicians is, yes, all right, we'll do your dirty work, but there's a price. We want support, we want resources, and we want hardware, because that is what we need. Not another inquiry into past mistakes.
Roy Johnson's still waiting to see us, sir.
I'm afraid he'll have to wait.
The Commissioner sends his deepest apologies for the delay. Would you like a coffee, sir?
No, thank you, Inspector.
One pair of trousers, slightly soiled. One contraceptive sheath, unused.
Thank you. Can I take him home?
Please do. And keep him well away from that flat. It's been used by a drugs ring.
Bloody hell. Simmons!
Right, sir.
Thank you.
So you're going straight there?
Yes.
I'm all right. Just a dizzy turn. Old age, perhaps. You have an inquiry about corruption in the Met. I want to talk to you about it.
By all means, Roy. We'll always listen to you.
I've just come from the Home Office.
I know. They phoned me.
I begged the Home Secretary. I practically got down on my knees and begged him not to allow the Met to sit on this inquiry the way it sat on mine.
Mr. Johnson, I give you my word that nobody is obstructing anybody.
The Met gave me its word 9 years ago, and my inquiry was obstructed.
But the Met is a completely different animal these days.
You're making the same mistake as Blamire. You're allowing your senior men to tell you only what they want you to know.
We've got rid of 800 detectives. I would have thought that's enough to satisfy any reasonable man.
95% of them on medical discharges and early pensions. What sanction do you have against a detective sitting in this building with his hand on £50,000 when he knows the worst he'll get if he ever takes it is an early pension, eh? Tell me.
Allegations of corruption are important, Roy, but it's just one of many problems on my desk.
Police officers involved in robbery and murder. What can be more important than that? For God's sake, you're allowing all the scum of London to point their finger at you and say they're no damn better than we are. And what are you going to do when it starts to unravel? Ask people to please obey the law? You've no right. You forfeited that right years ago. You've made a mockery of the law. In God's name, Mick, when is it all going to be stopped?
Can you call your wife?
There's been a problem on the allotment.
And I would say this. If you reselect Alan Payne tonight, then what you are in fact doing is allowing the Tory press to choose your candidate for you. Because the argument against me is that I will be attacked because of where I stand on certain issues. But think about it. If the Labour Party cannot have me as a candidate, it cannot have any candidate the Tory press will attack. Black candidates, gay candidates, any candidate who's ever done or said anything radical or so-called controversial. So this constituency party has an important choice here. It can accept my candidature by its own free democratic choice, or it can sit back and accept what's dished out to it by the Labour Party candidate factory, who hate the sight of me for one reason and one reason only. Because for 8 years, I've been hassling them to demolish Willow Lane flats. And why can't I? Because to demolish Willow Lane is to publicly admit 30 years of corrupt, lazy bastard, Tammany Hall-style politics, where greedy men line their own pockets and a spineless Labour MP did nothing, while whole communities were destroyed to make way for leaking, vermin-ridden, hungry dustbins. That's why. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You're winning. Thank you. Thank you.
Somebody said recently, the turkeys have voted for an early Christmas.
She's arriving.
Does she know I'm on the team?
Of course she does.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Conservative Party candidate, Claudia Seabrook.
Hi, guys. What a journey. Good health.
Welcome, Claudia.
Mr. Chairman, hello. Hello, David. Hello, Tom. Beattie, how nice to see you again. I hope your mother's better, is she? Hello.
She's just like her father was.
Yes.
The Labour Party has held this seat since 1924. Now, I, for one, think that's quite long enough. And I want you to know this. I firmly believe that this seat is now winnable by us.
Hear, hear, Claudia.
No, that's the spirit.
Now, I know I can rely on the party to help my campaign in a thousand ways. I mean, of course, the Labour Party. I also want it understood that I intend to fight strictly on the issues. I want a clean fight. Because when I've won, I want everyone to see that I won fair and square. Thank you, Alan.
Change? Apparently my son's a juvenile delinquent.
I'm Elaine.
Tosca.
Tosca. Unusual name.
Crazy name, crazy guy. What's your husband playing at, letting a lass like you come here?
I haven't got a husband. I'm a widow. What's your wife playing at, letting you come here?
I haven't got a wife.
I need your loving like the sunshine. And everybody's gotta learn sometime.
Hey, you need your bloody head examined. You know the cops came looking for you.
Yeah, I've been. I saw Nitty. Sorry. Can I stay with you tonight?
Stay with me? Oh, yeah, you can kick with Anthony and show him how to use an anti-tank weapon.
Sorry. Sorry about Anthony.
Change your heart.
Who's this?
Elaine.
Look Geordie. Around.
Shall I clear off then?
Yeah, good idea.
Tosca. Of course not Geordie. I need your loving. Like the sunshine.
I've asked Elaine to marry us.
Marry?
I haven't said yes yet, Geordie.
But she hasn't said no.
Does your wife know you're getting married?
I've told him, Geordie. You can ask us again when the divorce is finalised.
Divorce?
Yeah, divorce. Are you a parent or what?
Does your wife know she's getting divorced?
Hey, pack it in, will you?
Powder me nose.
How long's this been going on?
2¼ hours, but it makes no difference, Geordie. I'm going to marry her. I'm man.
Look, the fact that he's asked to see you means he's not going to ask for charges to be brought. You don't have to worry.
What do I have to see him for then?
To apologise. That's what for.
Anthony, everything will be all right.
What do you care? You both hate us. Me dad only comes home to change his pants and you've only got time for Bernadette and the poxy Labour Party. I'm going to live on my own.
Why my cabin? If you don't mind me asking.
Nothing personal. When I was your age, a year or two younger perhaps, my mother died. I felt so angry. I felt robbed, cheated. There was this big lad who'd been picking on me for about 6 months. The first time his shadow fell on me, after my mother died, I went straight home. I got a bloody big poker from the hearth and I nearly took his head off with it. And that was nothing personal either. My dad didn't half leather me. As yours? No, we don't go in for that these days, do we? I'm not sure what to think about that. You had something to say to me, apparently.
Sorry I did the damage. I've got some money saved up, if you...
No, I want nothing at all from you, son. Take your anger out on your football and take care of your mother. She's a gem. Would you like to tell me what you're so angry about? You know, there's nothing that can't be talked about. Nothing at all.
I and my dad splitting up.
I think it's inevitable. Yes. He's only there because he cares about you and Bernadette.
Crap.
He does, Anthony. In his way.
Where is he then? When you cry at night, is it because of me?
No, Anthony. That's not why I cry. Not you, son. Nothing that's happening is your fault, okay?
Why do you cry then?
I cry because I'm lonely. I know I've got you and Bernie, but I get lonely. It's a long time to live with someone if it's not really working.
When he goes, you can get somebody else, I suppose.
No, I don't think so.
I'm going to look after you.
Right, shall we get this one out of the way? Is it true you're gay?
My sexual orientation is not an issue. Next question.
Well, are you or not?
It doesn't matter. Okay.
No, I'm not gay. Now can we move on, please? This election will be fought on local issues, which is why it's an insult for the Tories to ship in a carpetbagger, the daughter of a disgraced Tory grandee passing through Newcastle on her way to a safe seat in Cheltenham.
This article that you wrote last year, it calls for action against Parliament if the Tories win the election. Is this what's caused the trouble between you and the Labour Party? Parliament's a charade?
You're quoting it out of context. And there is no trouble between me and the Labour Party. My candidature is endorsed by the Labour leadership.
Then why do they hate you?
Oh, come on, that's out of order.
Are you a member of Militants?
Look, can we get to the issues or else I've got better things to do than this?
So are you denying you're a member of Militant?
There's Mrs. Craig to see you. Are you willing?
He's told you that much anyway. I wasn't sure.
What do you want?
Is it true or not that your marriage is over and you're willing to give him his freedom?
He's had nothing but freedom.
Please, Mrs. Cox, this is hard for me as well. If Terry's lying, you'll never hear from me again.
Terry?
That's what he wants to be called. His real name.
Yes, the marriage is over. If he wanted a divorce, he only had to say so.
I think he's frightened.
Of what?
The settlement.
Oh, yes. He doesn't like being ripped off. Well, he needn't worry. If he wants a clean break, he can give me the house and forget about maintenance, or I'll buy the house off him, market price, and he can pay towards the kids.
Mary, if I hadn't have believed that this marriage was over, I would never...
I understand. Tell him to ring me. I want us to tell the kids together. Can't send you to do that.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. Be happy! I've got work to do, Elaine.
Trellis wasn't there before.
No. Well, I thought it looked good, like.
It does. It's good. You've cut back the Viburnia, but you've not been ruthless enough. Get the secateurs. Come on. You don't think you're off the hook yet, do you? You're my slave until I let you go.
For the kids.
Tell them. You know, put the blame on me. It's all my fault.
It would be better if you could say something yourself, Tosca. Not about blame. It doesn't matter. They need to hear it from you.
You tell them. God, I love them, you know. Tell them I love them.
Crying.
Oh, she'll be all right, son. We'll survive.
Go on, son. It's all right.
Okay, did everyone get the press release about the scandal of the Willow Lane flats?
Is it right you support the IRA?
Jesus wept. I don't suppose you'd like to tell me where you're getting all this, as if I didn't know.
Well?
I believe in a United Ireland.
British troops out?
Well, it's difficult to imagine a United Ireland with British troops in it, certainly. Now, can we move on...
It's IRA policy, isn't it?
Look, can we move on to the issues of this campaign, please? Housing, education, childcare, medical provision for this community.
That's IRA policy, isn't it?
I condemn all acts of terrorism from whatever source.
Did you tell your girlfriend that when she got 12 years?
What did I say?
Is this you, Colin?
Well, I gave it a helping hand. That is what I'm here for.
Well, it's legitimate in the circumstances, I think.
Latest straw polls.
Hutchinson 50%, Seabrook 39%, Liberal 11%.
I find that hard to believe, frankly. Are they ready for me, Beattie?
Claudia, we shouldn't be thinking of putting up a good show. Central Office wants to put some big guns into this constituency. That means they have expectations.
Hutchinson's our biggest vote winner. With what he's said and done over the years, we could hang him 10 times over.
As long as it's true, and as long as it's not personal attacks.
Of course.
Mr. Rashley.
Now, do I look like him? He's out, signing on. Hey, you lot, get off that flower bed.
I'm Nicky Hutchinson, the Labour candidate. I live in the constituency, in the Willow Lane flats.
Why, if you're not clever enough to get yourself out of there, you're not clever enough to be an MP.
If I'm elected, I'll campaign in Parliament for proper, decent houses for everybody.
Can you do out about these gypsies over the back? Kick their dirty arses out of it, and I might vote for you.
Well, the travellers have a housing problem of their own, you know.
I'm not talking about travellers, man. I'm talking about these dirty gyppos doing their business in people's back gardens.
How about a photo at the gypsy camp, Nicky?
Absolutely out of the question.
I mean, for Christ's sake, I can make a big enough bloody fool of myself without extra help from you.
Come on, Ben.
Well, according to tomorrow's journal, Hutchinson 42, Seabrook 38, Liberal 20.
Well, I just don't believe that.
Aye.
I need help.
I haven't supported you because I don't believe in dumping sitting MPs.
Payne was useless.
He was a clown. That didn't justify the abuse you and your friends threw at him in the last few years.
I live in a block of flats he helped get chucked up.
I know all about them, Nicky.
The campaign's a mess. They're all keen, but they're young.
Are you saying the seat could be lost?
No, I don't think that'll happen.
What do you want?
A campaign manager or advisor.
Which?
Frankly, I'll take what I'm given.
I'll advise you, not them. I want nothing to do with the trots.
Okay.
Your instincts are right. They've just been spoiled by incompetence. Local issues. No more press conferences. Get out in the knocker, stay there. I'll organise a rally, we'll round up some friends. You should be attacking Claudia Seabrook. It's her you're fighting, not the Labour Party.
I couldn't agree more. They can't be allowed to make a nuisance. There are special sites for them, after all. Can I give you a poster? Is there a poster for this lady? Oh. Oh, this is Stotty cake, is it? It's delicious.
Yes, more than that.
Claudia, what do you think of Nicky Hutchinson?
He's bloody good, you must admit.
Yeah. Just needs one more big push, though.
All right. There's your head on the block, Colin.
Fine.
Thank you.
Geordie.
Nicky-o.
Where have you been? Cops are still calling, right?
Yeah. They busted the guy I was working for. Pity. He was the head of drugs. I've been with this wife I know. Just come to pick up a few things.
Look, let's get together sometime after the election.
What election's that like?
You're never gonna change, are you?
It's all irrelevant, man. Oh. Best of luck, pal. Might as well be you as anybody.
Gotta go, see you, mate.
Nicky. I'm gonna clear out a few things, then take off. They don't really need to bust us, but if I stay around, they'll have to feel me collar sooner or later.
Where?
London, I suppose.
Sort of been here before?
Yeah. Funny, innit? Change the world this time, will you? Fucking well needs it.
See you, mate.
See you, pal.
Never in my political life, never in over 40 years of electioneering, have I ever come across such a concerted campaign of slurs and smears. This campaign has been a disgrace to the press, a disgrace to the Tory candidate and her party, and a disgrace to British politics.
Cheers, everyone. Thank you.
Thousands of them. I've talked to the police. It's completely illegal, but the damage is done.
It's got my address and phone number on it.
They're prepared to put a 24-hour guard on the flat.
Where the hell does all this hostility come from? All I want to do is improve people's lives.
Hello? Yes? No, he's not here. Now, wrong number, and actually, you're sick. What do you want us to do, Nicky?
What we've got to do now is hammer home what the leader is saying nationally. We don't have to bother with Hutchinson anymore. He's dead in the water. The candidate should talk about the sweeping changes we'll make across this country. An end to militant unions. An end to the dole scrounging. Crackdown on crime. Privatisation of the utilities. The candidate's final speech tonight should have the strength, power...
The candidate would like to smoke a cigarette. Does anyone mind?
No, of course not.
Carry on, Colin.
Well, I think I've said it all.
Really? You're being modest. You haven't nearly said it all. I've been studying some of your pamphlets from the last year or two. There's quite a lot you've left out. Wouldn't you like me to speak out on the legalisation of paedophilia, for instance? Or recreational drugs, including cocaine? No? What about armed support for the Contras and UNITA, toll roads, electronic tagging of offenders, the return of capital punishment, the privatisation of prisons, the scrapping of the National Health Service? I'd like to talk to Colin and Alan. Till tonight, everyone.
this costs me the election, Alan, I'll see to it that he can never show his face in the Conservative Party again.
Nothing to do with me.
You pack your bags, Mr. Butler, and go.
Claudia, I think Central Office might have something to say about that.
I'll ring them. I have. One more thing. Fuck off, you scruffy little man, back to your scruffy little friends.
Those who loathe us will fade away. Those who agree with us will inherit the party.
With one day to go, Liberal, 11%. Hutchinson, 40%. Seabrook, 49%.
Onwards.
Leave your messages here for Nikki Hutchinson.
Hi, Nikki, Alison. Just to say, if you didn't already hear it, they announced this evening the decision to demolish the Willow Lane flats. Well done, Nikki. You worked incredibly hard for this. How does it feel to be homeless? Well done, mate. And just to say, I'm still hopeful about tomorrow. And everyone's exhausted, but we all admire you, and we're all incredibly proud of you and this campaign. And whatever happens...
The heart of politics is people and how they want to live their lives. The recovery of the country from these wasted, bitter Labour years will not be based on dogma, but on common sense. People are no longer interested in which faction of the Labour Party is responsible for this or that mistake, this growing dole queue, that appalling block of flats. We know who's to blame. Because we have common sense. The common sense that says hard work should pay and success be rewarded. Yes, yes, hard work does pay off. Success is rewarded. The time has come for politicians to tell people the truth. The years of Labour division and deceit are over.
Did you go?
Travelling. Europe. I want to clear me head a bit.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm fine now.
Oh, sorry things got so nasty. I should have supported you earlier. We all should. It wasn't just you who lost that seat. We all did. You win again?
Me? No. God, no. Seeing as the net result of all my efforts was to hand a safe Labour seat for Claudia Seabrook, I think I'll bow out of active politics as gracefully as I can. Democracy will have to muddle along without me.
At least you got rid of that.
Yeah. I'd invite you in, but...
You got anything planned?
Well, I've been thinking about going to Nick.
The Ragua?
Or maybe Russia, if I can get in.
No, I meant more like tonight.
Oh, tonight? No. Nothing. Happy birthday, by the way.
I'm 35. I'm halfway and I'm fed up with being depressed. Let's go out and get mortal.
It sounds wonderful.
Actually, I mean, I'm forgetting Anthony. It's his birthday as well.
So we'll give him a birthday tea and I'll see you tonight.
No, I don't think... But I'll be in touch. I will.
How long's this going to go on? Why not? Why not tonight?
It wouldn't work.
Try me.
It's not a good time.
I've missed you. Over the years.
The kids are still confused. They have to come first.
Bill?
Beep-bop, beep-bop, beep-bop. Ben?
Oh, hello, Slubblop, beep-bop.
Hello, Slubblop, beep-bop, beep-bop. Beep-bop. Weed. Weed. Weed.
Weed.
Weed.
Tell little Weed to come over here. I think the farmer's coming back from his dinner! I love you, Elaine.
I love you, Terry.
Thank you.